Welcome back. Oh! Wow.
Are we okay? Whoa.
So what happened there was, I need to explain this.
Oh,
I just need to explain this if we can.
Let's run
through it.
Are we okay?
So what we've got here is we've got this fancy little thing called the Jip. Is that right? The Jip? Yep. So this thing's come back from the break, panning from the boys, and it's just whacked
big smash
into the big fella. And the poor fella, is his shoulder all right? Aww. You should go on compo. Just go on a little bit of compo. No, take your cans off. Off you go. Go and sort yourself out.
There we go.
Carl can shoot.
Multitasking. That's Georgia. Our boy.
You like that?
That's not a good shot, Carl. That one's not going to work. There we go.
Right.
There GG
go.
And
there
I
you
can
go.
Shoot
there.
This.
Back.
Wow. Back. Anyone can photograph Georgie.
Too much room above the head. Drop
Thank
down
you. And it's seamless here. It's seamless.
There you go.
Coming in at number three, it is survival of the fittest in Dummy Wars.
Wilkins' office, the man who is one of the most connected in the world with personal autographs from Mick Jagger, Keith Richards, and I think it's widely known within the whole industry that he does have the most in-depth little black book, not only in Australia,
oh,
but
yeah.
in the world. And we have managed to find it this morning.
Whoa.
Have a look at the size of that. And that is just a... Got a fair bit of reading to get through there, my friends. All right, we'll expose more of his secret, including his biggest ever secret after the weather this morning. Welcome back to Richard Wilkins' office in the deep, dark recesses of Channel 9. Over 25 years, Richard has kept many great secrets. This morning, we have managed to find his briefcase, get the lock, and break into it. Apparently inside is Richard's greatest ever secret.
It's like Pulp Fiction. Looking a little bit like Andy Warhol.
Very
much. So
clearly Stevie came in close.
Stevie.
That good. It's that good. It's that good.
Come back to us, Stevie.
Well, maybe it's the marble wash jeans that have just finally tweaked him.
Excellent stone wash. We'll find out what the heck was in there soon, but meantime, Most Clicked is next.
Yeah, welcome back to the program. It's good to have your company this morning. We've all donned our Dickie-esque wigs. What about Georgie's? How good's Georgie's wig?
Yeah, it's so good, isn't it?
That's fantastic.
I've been styling mine a la Dickie for some time.
Yeah, you have. It's lovely. It's lovely stuff. Well, it has been quite remarkable, hasn't it, Liz? Can you see the camera there?
Just. It's been a remarkable 25 years of Channel 9 for Richard Wilkins. Full of movie stars and rock legends.
Tell you what, I would have slayed them back in the 80s with this.
$2.89 billion quarterly profit. Handsome man, look at us. We could have been twins, Richard. Fantastic. It's good. Back to you guys. Happy Friday the 13th.
Well done, Roscoe.
You look like Alf Stewart. Jesus, Alf. Boy,
actually,
you know,
Alf. I thought you were saying I look like Alf, the alien.
Not that much hair. Here's Dickie. And Lachlan, what is your favourite Richard Wilkins moment?
Look, there's been so many. I look like I've got a dead rat on my head.
Hey, I gotta tell you, Richard Wilkins.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations, 25 years! Oh, my God! And you know what, I gotta say, I've spent 5 of those with you.
Yeah.
And I gotta tell you, every morning, we talk on the phone, we share a lot of laughs, and we share a lot of secrets. And oh my gosh, it'd be
all right.
We talk about on thank the you phone very much every you. Morning. Keep going. I love you, Richard. I love you.
Well, Richard, I love working with you, buddy boy. We're a bit like Sonny and Cher, aren't we?
I'm Cher. I'm Cher.
I'm happy to be Sonny.
Jeez.
The two of us, buddy boy, the two Richards, and I love working with you, buddy, and thank you very much indeed.
All right, getting clicks at number 3 as you're making breakfast this morning. Could you do this? And, of course, in case you need reminding, the group is going to join us right here on the Today Show tomorrow morning
at about 7:40.
Oh, that's just going to be amazing, Kat. It's going to be so amazing.
Oh, it'll take you back, you girls.
Oh, we're back there already.
Wow. Yeah, back when you were screaming for the Beatles and things in the 60s.
Sherbet?
Thanks.
Sherbet? I'll raise you your One Direction with a Zac Efron.
A lawsuit against their British counterparts. Wow. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, they're going to have to prove themselves, aren't they? To prove that they had the... please join us, Carl. they had the...
Did I miss something?
We're coming in at number three. It is survival of the fittest, bub against bub.
Okay. Yes. Hey, Nams, just quickly before you go, is that the Koshy show bag?
All right, getting clicks at number three. Check out this super strong baby's workout DVD.
And I must admit, I've had acupuncture on my cat as well as myself, so pets can have it too.
Wow.
Whoa.
Yes.
Success?
Well, yeah, he lost his leg, the cat.
Yeah, so... this is Darcy, isn't it?
No, that's my child.
Son.
Barry.
Oh, yeah.
Barry the cat.
Bazza.
Yeah, the three-legged puss.
This is the cat you had in LA that just ran around in circles.
Yeah, yeah.
But hang on, was the acupuncture before he lost the leg or
it
after?
It was after for pain relief, and it did work. So it works on people and pets as
Bazza.
Well. Poor Darcy's at home going,
it's not
me.
Darcy.
I'm not the cat.
What about Bazza, eh?
Bazza.
Big Bazza.
Darcy's still got two legs.
Yes.
That's good.
All right, getting clicks at number three is a terrific promo for BBC TV.
There you go, a little bit of sport at this stage, and we will update the footy tipping later. Mm.
Big last leg in the Tour de Turkey.
Yeah, were you watching, were you?
Doesn't have quite the ring about it, does it?
No. Oh, yes.
Juicy.
Okay. Well, the great thing about this new show is that there's lots of audience participation. The kids get involved, have to watch out for scary, scary ghosts who could be around any corner in this production with Scooby, Shaggy, and
Zoinks.
What's... Sorry, guys. Had curry for dinner.
Stevie, look out behind you.
What?
Zoinks!
Zoinks!
I love Scooby-Doo.
Oh, he's good, isn't he? You do a good Scooby-Doo.
Shaggy?
That's it.
Right.
On this great Australian production, which is touring New South Wales this week, kids will be on the edge of their seats as they try to help Shaggy and Scooby discover the ghost. And it seems like Scooby is on the scent. Let me just check my shoe. No, it's not there.
In there, Scooby. No! Come on, Scooby.
Oh, zoinks.
Drop it.
Dude, you need to get some sun.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of slip, slop, slapping going on there, that's for sure.
Scooby needs to put some shorts on too.
I did notice that,
early in the morning.
Need to be mentioned.
Coming up, Luke Mangan's making walk fried calamari with soy and ginger and garlic. Shaggy.
Three Scooby-Doo Live musical mysteries where you help work out who the ghost really is. Whoa!
Today Show!
And I would have got away with it too if it wasn't for you meddling kids.
Is that a ghost?
No! Let's go get him, gang!
By the way, I'm not that old.
Great line. Killer closer, Stevie.
All right, now at number three, as we've mentioned, we're talking to the dictator a little later today. He's going to be live in the studio, and here's what he is all about.
Is the man Lionel Richie. How good is he, Lionel Richie?
Good and moves. How good are suction cup shoes?
Well, I'll show you, Dickie.
Wow. Everyone stand up here. Sonia and Dad are here for the show. Right.
But let's all give it a go.
What are we going to do?
We're dancing on the ceiling.
Oh!
Careful that dress, Sonia.
Yeah. Makes me feel a bit sick.
This is awkward.
Can we do the throw from this angle?
Yeah, you can.
All right.
Well, oh, God, that makes me feel sick every time.
Here's what we've got for you. Oh. Roll tape.
Get we're out.
Let's go. Just go to our show.
Go.
Stop.